बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय क्लास। सो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सेकंड ईयर, एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी आर नाउअडेज़ वी आर डीलिंग विद यूनिट नंबर 3 एंड वी आर रीडिंग आवर लेसन फ्रॉम यूनिट नंबर 3.2 लिंग्वेन गॉड, दैट इज़ अ स्टोरी बाय टू पेंग चेन। सो वी हैव टू कंटिन्यू विद द स्टोरी दैट रीडिंग सिलेक्शन 3.2 Lingwen Gorge, a man should never lay by his post by Tu Pengcheng. So what has happened, what we have discussed in the previous lesson, let's recap. The story, it explains the title. In fact, the title of the story, it explains the central message delivered by a young boy standing watch over his little sister. The title highlights the central moral of the story, the importance of standing by one's duty and responsibility. On the other hand, it is not only the story, the narrator is a materials department chief overseeing a future railway project. The narrator who is narrating the story, he is overseeing a future railway project while traveling. What happened in the previous paragraph, unfortunately, while traveling, when he was traveling towards his destination, he faces snow, low visibility and terrible traveling condition. Worried that he might not get into some trouble, he finds a cave to stop and there he encounters a young boy standing by the doorway. What is the name of that boy? That is Chang Yu. Both the narrator and the boy, they started to discuss about different things. There the character of that boy, that is Chang Yu, just this explores in front of us. He is not a little boy as his age seems to be, but he seems to be incredible responsible. His attitude and his response towards narrator questions and his expressions, that is very significant. As when he asks him by he asks him that there is nobody at home, he replies in that way that I am nobody, neither you are considering me anybody. On the other hand, when he just calls him in direct way, he just makes it clear that he has some name and his sister has also. So not being only Chang Yu, 10 years old boy, he responds to the narrative questions in a very you can say different way, as he appears to be a person in himself. Okay, so let's start with our reading from to Peng Cheng from the lesson, that is Lingwen Gorge. As the boy asks him about the weather, and the narrator in a very light tone just asks, in a very light tone answers him that he is going to get the answer from the heaven rather, but he suggests that you have got your newspaper with you, so you may tell me about that. So what was the real matter to ask about that question, as he says that if it is going to be snow tomorrow, so his parents has to just quit the work. What does your papa do? So when he asked him that if it is snowing tomorrow, so we have to quit work. So the narrator asked, what does your papa do? What does your father do? He opens up mountain. He just does work on the mountain. The child replied proudly, where? So child is very much proud to tell him that his father just opens up mean he just you can say makes ways while on the mountains. He just give the opening to the mountains, and the child is very much proud to tell about that thing. Where? Chang Yu pointed with pursed lips at the work site opposite. Okay, so with his lips he just gives an idea that where his father is working. Okay, where his father is working, he just gives that with that his pursed lips means moving, can't say, with all his different gestures from the lips. I looked, all I could see was a searchlight beam. So what he can see, there was only a searchlight beam, mean that is a only a little, you can say, rays shining through the drifting snowflakes straight up into the heaven. In its light, I could vaguely discern a few dozen men who seemed, I could discern a few visible, sorry, yes, where we were. Okay, in this light, I could vaguely discern a few dozen men who seemed pasted to the side of the towering cliff, drilling holes for dynamite charges. The whole were like the steps of a ladder to the sky. So what he could see, what the job his father was doing, he could see that there was a searchlight and there was a simple beam, and on that flakes of that snow, he can see, as it was, the weather was not pleasant, it was, you can say, it was getting dark, it was hazy. So in that dim light, he can see few of the men. Those were working on the mountains, okay, and they were it seems to be that they are being pasted on the mountains. They are being as they were just getting their steps by the ladder to the sky. So it seems to be that they are just pasted on the mountain to get that dynamite fix, okay. To usko kya lagta hai, usko lagta hai ki main, I am observing those few of the men, and they are in a very vaguely discern, okay. They are in a very, and they are not having a clear, I couldn't see them clearly, and I could discern them. It was not easy to recognize them, उन लोगों को, उन आदमियों को, in that dim light, उस कम रोशनी में उनको शनाख्त करना, उनको पहचानना, recognize करना, perceive करना clearly, it was not easy. And it seems to be that they are pasted on the side of the towering town, और इस तरह से लग रहा था कि that on the towering cliff, sorry, on that cliff, उस चट्टान के ऊपर वो ऐसे लग रहा था कि that as they are drilling holes for dynamite charges, कि डायनामाइट को भरने के लिए, on those holes, it seems to be that they are just cling, they are just pasted on to the holes. As he was, he, as the mountain was having a, was very was having a height, on the other hand, he was, as the vision was not clear, so it seems to be the holes were like the steps of a ladder to the sky. ऐसे लग रहा था कि rather these steps, these ladders are they taking them to the sky, because of that, you can say, it could be the, because of that fog, because of that unclear weather. So they were, this seems to be like that, as you could see, as you could observe, whenever we just see people from the far away side, the people on the mountain, this seems to be very tiny and small, and it seems to be that they are pasted and they are clung to the mountain. How can tell you which one is your father at this distance, I asked. So the next question, as he, it seems to be that he, as the author was not clear about the people, there seems to be that they are just only pasted on the mountain. So how could you see that, who is your father? I can't see him plainly, but Pa says he can see me. So he says that I cannot see him, but my father says that he can see me. He says all he has to do is turn around. What he has to do? I often sit here so he can see me. What does his father say? When the author, as the narrator, was surprised by the vision, that he couldn't perceive the things very clearly. It was all vague. It was not clear. It was so dim to understand, to recognize, to perceive clearly in that dim light when the people are walking on the mountain. So he's asked that, how can you understand, how can you identify your father, that which among those all the men walking there? So he says that I do not need to see him. In fact, my father watches me. In fact, he just sees me. What does his father say? He says that I have to turn around, mujhe piche dekhna hai, and he can see me, that I am sitting here. That was it. So the author just, sorry, the narrator just astonished, the icy snow melted from my boots, as he just called the warm environment inside the that cave. My numb legs thawing out mean his numb legs, that were just numbs, they were because of the cold, they just started to get the heat. एक पेनफुली अटेम्प्ट टू हेल्प द सर्कुलेशन. ओके सो एज हिज लेग्स दैट वर नम बिकॉज ऑफ द कोल्ड आउटसाइड दे व्हेन दे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ही वाज फीलिंग देम एज दे वर नम सो दे ही वाज नॉट फीलिंग एनी ऑफ द पेन बट व्हेन इट स्टार्टेड टू गेट they started to get heat and they started to regain its the energy so it started to ache it started to pain painfully I stamped to help the circulation so in order to get the circulation in order to get it in order to avoid the pain he stamped it he just put the foot down heavily on the ground usne apna paon zameen pe mara. Okay, Cheng Yu waved his hand warningly. I understood. He was afraid. He just warned me. I understood. He was afraid I would wake his baby sister. So as he stamped his feet on the ground in order to get the circulation of the legs, Cheng Yu, who was watching his sister, he just gave him the warned him. Okay. उसने अपना हाथ क्या किया? He waved किया to just give him the warning that by all this noise his little sister might wake up. You really take good care of your sister. I expressed my praise towards him. Mama says my job is to look after her. When mama comes home, I can knock off, I can finish work. So this is very important. Please, girl says the role of that little boy, it appears to be like an a responsible person. He says that my work is to watch my sister, to look after my sister. When she will be around, my work is going to finish. So you are in the job every day. I hugged him. What does mama do? So he says that it means that you're all the time, you are on your job, you are doing, performing your work. What does your mother do? He pointed to the road below, to the cave. Then he pointed towards, so his father, his mother is also working. I could see a person standing by a telephone pole beside the road. So he can see a person who was standing near telephone ke khambe ke paas. He could see a person covered with snow. He looked like a white stone image as it was snowing. It seems to be that it was as she was completely covered by the snow. Apparently she was directing traffic, so it seems to be that she was directing traffic. The road, not very wide, had been blasted through the rock. It had been prepared, it had been constructed making the way from the rocks, as we just see the rock roads on the way to the hilltop stations, on the way towards different hill stations. So we just see towards the Murray and other sides. So it has been just prepared, the road has been prepared through blasted through the rocks. Ordinarily cars, mules, donkey and people no doubt streamed in both direction along the road 24 hours a day. Someone had to keep the traffic in order. So in order to keep the traffic in a proper way, in an order, traffic of different type of mode of you can say communication sorry mode of different transportation, such as there were donkeys, there were cars, there were mules, and there were the people. Those are coming towards the different direction, towards the road 24 hours a day. So it seems to be that someone has to take care of that traffic discipline. So what does the writer suggest? That he observes, the narrator observes, there is a person on the road that is completely covered by the snow, and she is directing the traffic. To direct the traffic in that difficult environment, in that difficult weather, is not an easy job. On the other hand, there are the different means of transportation, and there are the people, there are the different animals, there are the different cars as well. So in order to make all the things go in proper discipline and order, someone has to be there all the time. Today, because of the big snow, there wasn't many people or vehicles on the road. As you know it very well, that closes the construction site. So definitely there would be the transportation of different kind would be carrying the burden or the load of the different material things as well. So as it was snowy today, there was no vehicle on the road. She could very well have spent the day at home. But there she stood. There she would remain 3 months, 5 months, or 3 years, 5 years if need to be. Lekin, what happened if it was so snowy, it was not a good day today and the people would not be traveling. She could have spent her time in the home, but she didn't stay at home. She has to be there. She was so vigilant. She was so she seems to be so dedicated towards her duty that if she has to remain for a long time, she would remain there. Perhaps from time to time, she raised her head to gaze up at her child and her husband who was scaling the cliff between the mountains and the sky. And same of the gesture, same of the attitude is being observed by the female as well, from the female as well. So what the narrator observes that as the little child is very much sure that his father would be observing him, even just when he is climbing up the mountain. In the same way, the mother is just giving the signal that she is watching, she is observing, she is looking, she is gazing, she is just looking a long way and wondering towards her child and towards her husband who was who was climbing to the top of a mountain by a ladder, who was just jo kya kar raha hai jo uske upar chatano pe mount in that cliff that is taking steps between the mountain and the sky. When he paused to wipe the seat from the brow, could he see the determined figure of his wife or the tiny image of his little boy? So same is the case ki agar jab wo apne liye, in the same way the father, when he you just take a pass from to wipe this sweat from his brow, when he take a pass, a little pass, can he see the his wife who's so dedicated towards his duty or towards his little boy? Even though it was a snowy, windy night, even though the worker, his wife and his children couldn't see one another clearly, I was sure they could feel a mutual loving encouragement and sense that each one was looking forward to the moment of family reunion. So he says that it seems to be rather they couldn't see each other clearly, but it seems to be that they are waiting for the moment when they will be together again. There was a connection among all three of them that the child is very much sure that his father is observing him. The mother is very much sure that her child is taking care of the sister, and the father is observing. Can he see that three of them how they mutually work together for their family? I glanced at Cheng to you. The child had placed his hand in his sleeve and pulled his neck into his collar. He kept dozing off. It seems to be that he was dozing. He wants to sleep. You are liable to catch a chill. Better go into the bed and go to sleep. Then he suggested, it seems to be that as you are out from your bed, that you might get your cold. So it's better that you must go to sleep. He looked at me dreamily for a moment. Dreamily, as he was dozing, as he was feeling a little sleepy for a moment, probably thinking that his parents had returned. His parents had returned. When he realized who I was, he shook his head violently. No, I wouldn't. Why not? No, I wouldn't. Then when he realized I was, he shook his head violently in that hard way, and then said, no, I won't. Why not? He rubbed his head with his feet. Papa and Mama say a man should never leave his post. Please underline this sentence. That shows the character of that little boy. So as he could see that the narrator could see the little child that was dozing off, he needs to have some sleep, and there was so cold outside as well. So he just suggested the boy to go to bed, but the boy just didn't like that idea. He said, no, my father and mother, Papa and Mama says a man should never leave his post. Underline this sentence, that is very important. In fact, That is the idea or the moral, the title of the lesson that was being conveyed. I hugged him tightly, I pressed my cheek against, then I rose, buttoned my coat, pulled my head down firmly, left the cave and walked down the path. Following the road that had been blasted through the rock, I pushed on, the words of the child echoing in my head. A man should never leave his post. A job was waiting for me. I wanted to reach my destination without any further delay. So that words encouraged the narrator as well. He just pulled himself again and he managed himself. He buttoned his coat and he just traveled. He just moved toward his destination where he has to go towards that site place. As he has been told the idea or the motto of the life that a man should never leave his post. So he says that a job was waiting for me. So he learned the little, this secret of life, the successful life, from a little boy. So that was all for this story. But what we have come to know that the character of Chang Yu, it is very important. On the other hand, what is the idea of the story, that is very important. So what is the character of that Chang Yu? He seems to be a very, he is in fact an incredible, responsible, thoughtful and caring child. He certainly seems a good son and a loving brother as well. He is obedient, but most importantly he is dutiful. His parents are able to rely on him and he does his job with the sense of true purpose. On the other hand, the story reflects the importance of work, no matter how big or small. Doing one's duty, even when it is difficult, is a holy patriotic act. The story suggests if every one of us perform our duties with earnest dedication, we can progress very well. Okay, so the very final paragraph just leads the narrator to realize a valuable lesson from that little boy. Right, the final paragraph suggests the narrator, by just getting that lesson, continues to on to his work with the final paragraph. So he learned that lesson of the life for dedication and determination in the face of hardships from that little boy. So it is not only applicable towards one situation, it is applicable towards all of us, as it is our moral duty and obligation to never to leave our post, either we are a teacher, either we are students, either we are a citizen, in any of our role, in any of our capacity, we have to perform our best. Thank you so much. This was all for today's lecture. Hope that you have got all the points. Inshallah, see you tomorrow with its exercise question. Take care. Allah.